serial communication program, that is program for transmitting a string using 8051. So register required for serial communication program. The first register is serial port control register, that is SCON register. So register is 8 bit, and these first two bits are related to mode of operation. Here for transmitter program we are going to use mode 1. So for mode 1 here this bit should be 0 and 1. Then SM2 bit is used for mode 2 and 3 of serial transmission. So for mode 1 it will be in don't care condition. REN is receiver enable terminal. Since we are writing transmitter program, this bit is again in don't care condition. This TB8 will act as a 8 bit of a transmission, and RB8 will act as a 8 bit of reception, but these two bits are used in mode 2 and 3. So for mode 1 these are again in don't care condition. TI is transmitter interrupt and RI is receiver interrupt. So if we are using the interrupt, then automatically controller will set these bits to 1. So TI bit will be set to 1 after transmission of 1 character, and RI bit will set to 1 after receive. So these bits will be set automatically by microcontroller. So for initialization of SCON register, these bits are also in don't care condition. So in program we have to initialize SCON register with value 40H. Next register is power mode control register, that is PCON register, and SMOD bit of PCON register is used to set the baud rate. So in mode 1 for baud rate calculation, this formula is used. F baud, frequency of baud rate, is equal to 2^2 SMOD, that is this bit can be 0 or 1, divided by 12 into 32 into frequency of oscillator, divided by 256 minus TH1. So we are using oscillator frequency as 11.0592 MHz. So we have to find what count should be stored in TH1 register. Using this formula for baud rate of 9600, that is for transmission we are using baud rate of 9600. So by substituting baud rate here and oscillator frequency, we can find count to be stored in TH1 register. So in TH1 register we get FD. So FD should be stored in TH1 register related to, that is related to baud rate 9600. We are using SMOD bit as a 0. Now next register is TMOD register. Here for serial communication, baud rate is generated using timer 1 in mode 2. Mode 2 is auto reload mode, so it is used to generate a clock frequency for serial transmission. So for that we have to initialize TMOD register also. So for TMOD register, 4 higher bits are used for timer 1 and lower 4 bits are used for timer 0. Since we are using timer 1, all these timer 0 bits will be in don't care condition. Now this gate bit is used to check whether we are going to start a timer using software instruction or hardware signal. Since we are going to use software instruction, this bit should be 0. Now we are using timer, not a counter, so this bit should be 0. Then mode 2 we are using of timer. So for mode 2, M1 is 1 and M0 is 0. So the count we have to store in TMOD register is 20H. Now writing a program in assembly language. So first we will store the string which we want to transmit in a lookup table, and for that we'll write the string at the end of the program. So string is the name which I am giving to the string which I want to transmit. So we have to write this string like this: string, any name we can give to this string, then db. That means the 8 bits are required to store ASCII value of each character in string. And suppose we want to transmit string as communication, so we'll write this string in single quote, and to indicate end of string we'll write here 0. So 0 indicates end of string. So each character of this string will be stored in a string variable, that is in lookup table. So first address so this initialization will write at the end of the program. So first we'll initialize all register while writing a program. So first register is SCON register, that is serial communication control register. So we have computed a value which is to be stored in SCON register, that is 40H. So we'll initialize SCON register. Next we'll initialize TMOD register. No need to initialize PowerCon register, that is power control register, because by default SMOD bit is 0 and we are using SMOD bit 0 in our program. So no need to initialize this PCON register. If you want to change a baud rate, then if we want to multiply baud rate by 2, then SMOD register should be 1. So this factor will be multiplied by 2. But since we are using this SMOD 0, no need to initialize PCON register, because by default it is 0. Then next we'll load a count related to our baud rate, that is 9600, in TH1 register. So TH1 should be initialized with value FDH. So this is all about initialization of register. After this we'll start a timer 1. So here we are using timer 1 in mode 2. So to generate a clock signal or baud rate, we have to start timer 1. So for that we'll write instruction set bit TCON.6. TCON.6 bit is TR1 bit, so that we are initializing with 1. So timer 1 will start and it start generating a clock signal that is required for baud rate. Then next we'll use a DPTR register as a pointer to the string which we want to transmit, and this string we have stored in the memory location. So this DPTR register should point to first character of the string. So for that we have to initialize DPTR register like move DPTR, and since we are using it as a pointer to variable string, so we have to write like this: hash then string. So now DPTR will point to first character of the string. Then next we have to use this instruction. Since we have stored string in program memory, to read a character from program memory we have to use instruction MOVC, and the format of instruction is A, at A plus DPTR. The DPTR register is having address of first character, and here for this instruction the DPTR contents are added with accumulator, but we want a memory location address which is stored in DPTR. So we'll initialize accumulator register with value 0. So since accumulator is 0 and DPTR contains the address of first character, the contents of address location will be stored in accumulator. That means in this example, ASCII value of C will be now stored in accumulator. Now this ASCII value we want to send serially. So for that, we have to store this ASCII value into buffer register. But before that, we have indicated end of string with this 0 character. So we'll write an instruction: if in accumulator the data is 0, that means jump 0 to exit. So jump in 0 instruction checks contents of accumulator. So if contents of accumulator are 0, it indicates end of string, and since it is end of string, we'll go to exit label. If it is not end of string, that means in accumulator, if 0 is not there, then contents of accumulator we want to transmit serially. So we'll store this contents of accumulator in serial buffer register. So as soon as we store contents of accumulator in serial buffer register, this contents will be transmitted serially. Now after complete transmission of 8 bit of this first character, controller will automatically set transmit interrupt bit. So we are using polling method, so we continuously check this transmit interrupt bit, that is TI bit. So I'll write here jump not bit TI to L1. L1 label will be given to same instruction. So if TI is 0, that means character is not transmitted, it will continuously execute this instruction. If character is transmitted completely, then TI bit will be set to 1 and it will execute the next instruction. In next instruction, since one character is transmitted, we want to transmit next character. So for that, we'll clear TI bit so that next time controller should be able to set this bit. So clear this transmitter interrupt bit, and now we want that pointer should point to next character till it becomes end of string. So to point to the next character, we have used DPTR as a pointer. So we'll increment contents of DPTR register so that it will point to next character in the string. Since now DPTR is pointing to next character, we have to execute this instruction. So again in accumulator we'll store 00. The address of next character is in DPTR, so that ASCII value will be stored in accumulator. We'll check whether it is end of string or not. If it is not end of the string, character will be stored in S buffer register, from where it is transmitted serially. We'll check a transmitter interrupt flag. If it is 1, it should be clear, and again increment DPTR. So after this step, we have to write here S jump back. So back label should be given to this instruction. So these instructions will be repeated till the last character 0 is read by this DPTR jump 0 instruction. So for this exit, we have to write here label exit and here S jump to exit. So now after transmission of complete string, continuously microcontroller will execute this instruction. After writing this program, then we'll write a string in a memory. So for that we'll use DB, and whatever string we want to transmit, that should be written in single quote, and to check end of string, we are transmitting character 0. So this program will transmit serially the string communication. Any string can be transmitted using this program.